What's good, my demonic homies? In today's video, it's going to be pretty simple. I'll be briefly showcasing each demon form abilities you have access to and showing off what it is they do, then covering over tips and combos you can do in a PvP setting. If you haven't done so already, feel free to check out my Twitch channel and previous Shadowhunter build guide. Links will be in the description. With that being said, let's get this shit started. First ability up is Ruining Rush. This ability is best used as your gap closer and engage, possibly disengage. You'll often find yourself having to gap close your target in demon form, and this ability is one of those options used commonly. It will CC your target and slightly push them back a bit. It's unprotected with low stagger. Next up, Death Claw. This ability is mainly used as damage filler and CC connectors. It works pretty nicely before and after some of your close range abilities in demon form. It not only CCs your target, but also shoves them backwards just a bit. It's a quick and easy attack with solid damage and CC. It's a low stagger with frontal attack type and counts as a counter attack. Next up is Destruction. This one's going to be one of your close range AoEs. It only CCs your opponent for a short time, but has lots of damage to offer. This ability is predominantly used to help finish you off your targets or in the middle of your combo. Since it has a decent close range AoE, it's best used when two or more targets are close to each other. Its stagger is mid to high. Next up is Gore Bleeding. Bleed is going to be your main form of hard CC. It's not only quick to activate, but also does considerable amounts of damage. If you happen to catch your opponents with this ability, they will be stuck in this animation until scratching finishes into a push CC. It's great for the CC connection and right after your engage. Its staggering is mid to high. Next up is Leaping Blow. This ability is one of your high risk, high reward engages in your kit. It does insane amounts of damage and sets up an earthquake CC. However, it is unprotected. It's one of those abilities that works best when targets are bundled up together and or when your opponents have run out of CC options or disengages, or perhaps are not paying attention to your positioning. Either way, this ability hits hard with a solid CC right after. This ability has mid to high stagger. And lastly, Blood Massacre. This ability is the strongest damage AoE you have in your kit. It's unprotected with an animation buildup that makes this ability a high risk, high reward. Its AoE size is not bad and works best with bundled up or CC targets. It sends them flying if successful and has high staggering levels. If you know the best time to use this ability, it's one of those abilities that can easily get you a double or triple kill if used properly. Small thing to mention is your spacebar dodge. In this demon form, your dodge has become significantly longer, allowing you a huge gap closer to initiate a catch or to engage the backlane much easier. This ability works perfectly to flow into your other forms of CC and damage to start off your combos. Now that you're familiar with the abilities, I'm going to show you some small combo pieces and engages that you can use for PvP scenarios. First up, I'll show you some engages you can use in PvP. You can use spacebar into R for a quick and instant CC engage. This is going to be the easiest and safest way to engage your opponents and connect your CC. The spacebar is always going to be the best way to engage with your R ability. It's the quickest CC you can dish out. You'll find yourself using this quite often and will probably be the most consistent way to get into the backlane as well. Next is spacebar into A. This is also one of the safest way to engage if you're going to use your A ability. It not only covers a decent amount of distance, but it allows you to use your dash ability for protection. Then into the unsafe A ability engage. The abilities also flow quick and nicely after each other, almost like a cancel. And since these two are fairly quick, it can sometimes catch your opponents off guard if they do not react quickly. Next is the spacebar into Q. This is the longest engage you'd have in terms of distance and also works well if you carefully plan your engage. It's the same scenario, safe dash into unsafe Q engage. This one works well if you choose not to risk the A ability into your opponents and would rather use your Q to push in instead. It also keeps your A ability open for better and safer opportunities. And lastly, of course, these two abilities flow quick and nicely after each other. And last engage to mention is your Q ability into R. If you choose not to use your spacebar for engage and would rather save it for the backlane push or to escape, the Q ability works out as well. And the R ability helps to connect your CC and to continue your combo if successful. And lastly, we have the combo pieces for demon form. First and foremost, combo piece is A and S. This is the most high risk, high reward combo piece you can pull off on demon form. You have to be smart about when to use this without getting interrupted too much. Otherwise, both of these abilities do an insane amount of damage that if both are casted together without interruption, you can easily kill off squishy targets with ease. Another variant of this would be the A ability into spacebar behind the enemies, then S. This one would be the safer option if you really wanted to pull off the S ability. A ability would get your opponents to focus on your position initially, only for you to teleport near or behind them and cast the S ability in a safer position. Isn't necessarily a guaranteed option, but it does catch your opponents off guard. Only thing stopping you is large AoEs or quick reaction from the opponents. Next combo pieces are going to be some example combos you can do in demon form. A ability into S ability into Q into E into W and R. S ability into A into E and R. Q ability into R into W and E. And if possible as extension, L and B for the damage filler and CC stall. A ability into E, into R, into Q, and W. S ability into Q, into E, W, and R. And that wraps up this demon form guide for PvP. Hope this helps you guys to familiarize yourself with the demon form and what kind of movement, combos, and engages you can perform. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. And be sure to check out the links in the description below as well. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.